back, you're watching Overdrive. Just earlier this month, Mercedes-Benz launched their very first ground-up electric vehicle in the country, the Mercedes-Benz EQE. Now, this makes it the brand's fifth electric vehicle to be launched in the country. And what better place to enjoy the zero-emissions SUV than in the clean and crisp air of Kashmir? Take a look.
You see, if you want a long-range EV at the moment, and a luxurious one at that, the Germans are your best bet. Not the Japs, not the Koreans, not even the Brits. Cars like the Audi Q8, e-tron, or the BMW iX are the best all-rounder EVs in that sense. And now, they have a new competition. This, the Mercedes-Benz EQE SUV. It's the SUV version of the EQE Saloon, which is unlikely to come to India. Because you see, from an Indian standpoint, the E-Class long wheelbase that is sold to us is unbeatable on comfort. And if you're going to make a green statement instead by going electric, the EQE SUV offers better practicality than its saloon sibling. A much larger boot, easier ingress and egress because SUV, a higher seating point, more legroom, decent knee room and foot space, and excellent seating comfort too. The SUV also gets you the larger hyperscreen, so it gets you more tech compared to the saloon. The CarPlay looks beautiful. It also gets you this big map if you want. If you move to the 360-degree cameras, it gets you a really nice view of the surroundings. And if you don't have such great views to gaze at when you're charging the car maybe, there are also different apps, games that you can play on the screen, or you can even watch movies. And because the maps or the GPS takes center stage, it also comes in handy when you're road tripping.
You can't play the games or watch movies on the move though. There are facial recognition cameras inside the car that instantly identify when the driver is looking at the screen than the road for too long. And then all sorts of warnings start coming up.
Now, more tech distinction for the EQE SUV compared to the saloon comes in the form of the twin motor setup. You have one electric motor on each axle. Now, it not only gives you a colossal 858 Newton meters of torque, but it also gives you the electric 4MATIC or the electric all-wheel drive system from Mercedes-Benz. Now, it is more of a safety system, of course. It is safety oriented more than performance. But yes, under acceleration, hard acceleration, it will give you better grip. And when you get it right, the acceleration is very brisk. You can go from 0 to 100 in under 5 seconds. And top speed, since we are on the topic of performance, is restricted to about 210 kilometers an hour. Furthermore, the electric 4WATIC system also gets you the off-road mode. And in the off-road mode, you get a lot of information when you're driving off the road. And like the GLC, you also get the transparent bonnet view, which essentially uses data from the front camera, then stitches it all together, and then tells you of any hurdles that you may have at the front axle. It works only on the move, of course. Now, talking about the off-road mode, it'll also make sure that the 4MATIC system or the torque distribution, the brake force distribution, all of that is optimized to ensure that you get good grip when you're going over uneven terrain or maybe wet foliage like we are right now, or maybe over loose surfaces, etc. Apart from the increased ground clearance that you get for this car compared to the EQE Saloon, you can also raise it even further to go over uneven terrain like this. Now, this is the difference between a born electric platform versus vehicles that are based on existing ICE platforms and then modified to be electric. This one, however, the born electric, manages to get a much better ground clearance. So going over undulated surfaces, deep potholes, tall speed humps, or even just taking off the beaten path, all of that is possible with this car. Much better than what you could have managed with the EQC. In fact, much better than what you can also do with the EQB electric. We've seen with the EQB and the EQS that usually there's only a 8 to 10% difference between the WLTP claimed range versus what we've really got in the Indian driving cycle. However, for this car, I'm guessing it's going to be a slightly higher drop. I'm guessing it could be anywhere between 15 to 20%. A real world range of about 400 to 420 kilometers should be doable with the EQE SUV.
Blame it on the twin motor setup and the always alert 4MATIC system maybe. In fact, that is also the reason why the EQE SUV doesn't quite match the range estimates of the saloon.
This is a 30 kilowatt charger, But this car also supports 170 kilowatt DC fast charging, meaning that you can take complete advantage of the 180 kilowatt DC fast chargers installed at around 20 Mercedes-Benz dealerships already. And then there are similarly specced or comparable fast chargers from Shell, from some other manufacturers, etc. So this car can take advantage of all of that. About 45 minutes of charging with a fast charger will give you enough juice for another long haul, which means that road tripping with the EQE SUV shouldn't be a problem at all.
The EQE SUV has a single-step transmission. The performance is brisk and enjoyable.
This car also comes with the airmatic system, the air balance system. So essentially, that will not only give you an excellent ride quality when you put it in the comfort mode, it will also gauge the number of people that are sitting inside the car, the luggage, etc. It will essentially gauge the load and then automatically set the ride height, automatically set the damping so that you get a comfortable ride, so that all the optimal aerodynamics are also achieved. All that is possible. Now, when you do engage sport mode, the powertrain also becomes a lot more responsive. It feels a lot freer. In the comfort or the eco modes, it just feels a bit restrained.
The car climbs inclines briskly too, and typical to an EV, there's never a dearth of power or torque. It's easy to maintain a steady power delivery, and in these narrow winding roads around Gulmarg, the EQE felt easy to maneuver. While the cabin feels roomy and the visibility for all the passengers is quite decent, for the driver, the high dashboard and the wedge shape of the car, which leads to a broad profile for the A-pillars, it can hamper cornering visibility quite often.
And this wedge shape is the reason why I'll probably not buy the EQE SUV over the GLE.
For me, the ideal EQE SUV would have been the GLE with an electric powertrain, but the designers at Mercedes-Benz think differently. They need the EQE to look more like the EQS.
When you disassociate the EQE from its ICE predecessors, then you'll see a lot of value from an EV standpoint. You see, it's fully loaded with all the bells and whistles that this platform or this car has to offer. So compared to its global variants, you don't really have to tick a long options list. Most of it is right there. And then you add the niceties that the brand brings to you, like excellent service, a really long warranty package, a really good buyback package as well. So when you put it all together, when you combine all these things, the EQE easily becomes the best buy in the segment.
The Mercedes-Benz EQE will go up against the likes of the Audi Q8 e-tron as well as the BMW iX in the luxury electric SUV space. We will take a very short break here on the show, but coming up on the other side, we get you acquainted with what the brand calls the SUV of scooters. Stay with us, you're watching Overdrive.